Spotlight, 11 класс, Grammar Reference Section, Module 8. Inversion. We can invert the subject and the auxiliary verb in the sentence to give emphasis. If there is no auxiliary verb, we use do, does, present simple, or did, past simple. In the interrogative, inversion occurs after certain expressions when they are placed at the beginning of a sentence. These are barely, hardly ever, when, in no way, in, under no circumstances, little, never, before, nor neither, nor sooner than, not even once, not only, but also, not since, not till, until, nowhere, only in this way, on no account, on no occasion, only then, really, scarcely ever, when, seldom, etc. Not even once has he offered to help us. Rarely do we go out during the week. Note, only after, only by, only if, only when, not since, not till, until, used at the beginning cause inversion of the subject and the auxiliary verb in the main cause. Not until he told me his full name did I remember where we had met. In conditionals, when should, where, had, past perfect, are placed at the beginning of the sentence. Note that if is omitted. Should we decide to come by, give us a call first. If you should decide, type 1, were he more honest with himself, he would admit his mistake if he were type 2. Had I known about the reputation of the restaurant, I wouldn't have gone there. If I had known type 3. After so such to such degree in result clauses placed at the beginning of a sentence, so angry was he that he couldn't utter a word. After s neither nor so to express agreement. I had chicken for dinner, so did I. So is used to agree with an affirmative sentence. Peter isn't doing well at maths. Neither nor is John. Neither nor are used to agree with a negative statement. George's parents spent a lot of money on his birthday present, as did his grandparents. In the following structures, we invert the subject and the main verb. After adverbs of place, there goes the last but there it goes. Here are your glasses, but here they are. In direct speech, when the reporting verb comes after the quote and the subject of the noun. That was a good film, said Bill. Bill said is also possible, but that was a good film, he said. So, neither nor. So, plus auxiliary verb, plus personal pronoun, noun. Positive addition to a positive sentence. Helen drives a sports car. So does Jack. Jack drives a sports car too. Sarah went to Spain last year. So did we. We went to Spain too. Neither nor plus auxiliary verb plus personal pronoun noun. Negative addition to a negative sentence. Peter didn't come to the party. Neither nor did James. Not so didn't James. Quantifiers, some, any, no, every, and their compounds. Some, any, and no are used with uncountable nouns and plural countable nouns. We need some eggs and somebody, positive, interrogative, negative, people. Somebody, someone, everybody, everyone, anybody, anyone, nobody, no one, not anybody, things. Something, everything, anything, nothing, not anything, places. Somewhere, everywhere, anywhere, nowhere, not anywhere. There's somebody at the door. Is anyone here? There is no one here. There isn't anyone here. I've looked everywhere, but I can't find him. Note, would you like something to eat? Offer, what's wrong? Have you lost something? Expect a positive answer. If anyone calls, tell them to leave a message. Anyone who wants to come must give me their names now. You can come anytime. It doesn't matter who or what time. We use some and its compounds, somebody, someone, something, somewhere, etc.
In the affirmative, my jacket must be near here somewhere. We also use some and its compounds in the interrogative for offers or requests. Would you like some cake? Can I have some milk with my tea, please? We use any and its compounds, anyone, anything, etc. in interrogative sentences. Has anyone code? Not any is used in negative sentences. There isn't any fruit in the basket. Any and its compounds can also be used with negative words, such as without, never, rarely, I have never met anyone like him. Hardly any is used in affirmative sentences with uncountable nouns and plural countable nouns. There is hardly any salt in the soup. There were hardly any children at the park. When any and its compounds are used in affirmative sentences, their meaning is it doesn't matter what, who, where. You can say anything you want to the journalist. It doesn't matter what. Anyone can take part in the competition. It doesn't matter whom. No and its compounds are used instead of not any in negative sentences. The verb is then used in the affirmative. They haven't got any money. They've got no money. They didn't buy anything. They bought nothing. There wasn't anybody in the room. There was nobody in the room. Every is used with singular countable nouns. Every student in the class laughed with the teacher's joke. Note, we use a singular verb with compounds of some, any, no, and every. There is someone in the room. Everything seems to be going fine. Each, every. Every is used with singular countable nouns. It refers to a group of people or things and means all, everyone, everything, etc. Every student has a library card, all students. Each is also used with singular countable nouns, but it refers to the members of the group separately. Each visitor was given a day pass, each visitor separately. Everyone and each one can be followed by of. We normally use each when we talk about two people or things. We use every when we talk about three or more people or things. She owns two flats and she decorated each one of them beautifully. Paul has written many novels. Every one of them has been a bestseller. A few, a little, a few and few are used with plural countable nouns. A little and little are used with uncountable nouns. A few means not many but enough. We have a few apples. We can make an apple pie. Few means hardly any, almost none, and can be used with very for emphasis. There were very few visitors in the museum. A little means not much but enough. It's a little cold. Would you like me to close the window? Little means hardly any, almost none, and can be used with very for emphasis. We have very little time left. We must hurry up.